Hello and welcome. Thank you for joining us today. We are continuing with our series on attitude, and the series is called Our Attitude Matters. And our attitude really matters because our attitude can either help us or hinder us. It can prevent us or propel us into the things that God has for us and into all that God has for us, especially today. So the next 24 hours can drastically change if our attitude changes, if we change our attitude about everything that we see around us. And so today we are looking at an attitude that we can avoid. There are attitudes that we can develop, and there are certain attitudes that we can avoid. And today we are looking at this attitude, which is the indifferent or apathetic attitude. It was John C. Maxwell who said, "Attitudes are contagious. There's only one thing more contagious than a good attitude, and that's a bad attitude." So as much as good attitudes are contagious, bad attitudes are even more so. So we need to take note of that, right? So indifference to the needs around us, indifference to the pains of people, indifference to the challenges that people might be undergoing. And how does that creep into our lives? How does that happen? We take on an indifferent attitude when we become very self-absorbed and when we become very self-focused. So there's nothing wrong in being focused, but when we focus on ourselves to the exclusion of everything that happens around us, then the indifferent attitude or apathetic attitude becomes entrenched in us. In Luke chapter 10, the Lord Jesus narrates the parable, or teaches the parable, about the Good Samaritan. There was a man who was going from Jerusalem to Jericho, and there were some robbers who robbed him of all his belongings. They left him beaten and wounded. So he was there by the wayside, and there's a priest who comes, who sees this man in this condition, but he goes on. There's a Levite who comes, who sees the same person, and he goes on. And there's a Samaritan who comes, who sees the person, who cares for him, who takes him and gets him to a place of refuge, and admits him in an inn, and also takes care of all his expenses. So now when we look at these two others who were indifferent, you know, we learn some things. We can learn probably the reason. There are some reasons why people can be indifferent, or why you and I can be indifferent. It could be because they were very focused on their agenda, on their plans, what they had to do. That could be one reason. Secondly, it could be that they felt overwhelmed by the need that they saw and didn't know how to help, and thought maybe that we don't have the capacity to help, nor the time, nor the resources, and they moved on. Reason number three could even be a regional or a language prejudice or a bias. You know, when we have a prejudice about a certain people group, then we could be end up being indifferent or apathetic towards their needs and towards their pain. So the downside of this is that we distance ourselves from people, we cut away from people, we actually block people off. And these very people could be the ones that the Lord sends our way so that we could minister to their needs, so that we could do something, that we could reach into their lives and do something. And also, in distancing ourselves from such people, we also distance ourselves from the plans and the purposes of God. The only antidote for this indifferent attitude, or the cure, is to get God's perspective and to get His heart. We all know this verse, John 3:16. It says that God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. So God looked at humanity that was suffering because of sin, and God did not distance Himself. He reached out to a suffering world. He reached out to a suffering humanity. And He reached out in love. He reached out in compassion. And He reached out with great generosity, that He gave His only begotten Son. And so we have that as an example. God was not indifferent. God did not distance Himself from us because we were caught up in sin. In fact, while we were yet sinners, He did this. He died for us on the cross. So let us ask the Lord today. Let us ask for compassion, for a heart of compassion. Let us ask the Lord to break down any apathetic and indifferent attitude that we might have in our own lives. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you. Lord, we pray that you would change our outlook. Give us eyes to see the things that you see, Lord. When you look at humanity, Lord, what do you see, Lord? Give us the same eyes, Lord. Give us that same heart of compassion that you have, Lord. And Lord, we pray that we would be able to carry out our responsibilities and our tasks, O God, Lord, with a lot of focus, but not excluding, Lord, the things that we see around us, God, those needs that we see around us, Father God. Lord, we pray that you'll give us a sensitive heart to discern between, O God, what is unnecessary and what is necessary, what comes from you, O God. And Lord, we pray that you'd give us the heart to pursue that, Lord. We thank you. We give you all praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.